fallen bars. Listening is louder than a lecture. Listening is louder than a shout. But love, but love, love can change the world. Ought to we still believe that love, love can change the world. Ought to we still believe in love, love. God is love, our God is love, and love can change the world.
An open hand,
an open hand is stronger than a fist is. An open hand is stronger than a fist. And wonder is more valuable than Wall Street. Valuable than gold.
But love,
but love, love can change the world. Ought to we still believe that love, love can change the world. Ought to we still believe. Stop this dreaming of a better world. And may we never stop believing in the impossible.
One more time.
And may we never stop this dreaming of a better world. And may we never stop.
There's a world at war, caught in suffering, silent casualties. Oh God, grant us peace. In these sleepless nights, I can hardly breathe. Despite brutality, I know that will be free. I know that I will be free.
So let the light in, keep it shining. Let it break into the darkness. All the love dares us to see. We'll all be free.
In these desperate times, love will hold us here. Love will join our hands, teach us to have no fear. So we lay our hate down to wash their feet. When we see our brother, oh, we'll all be free. Yes, we'll all be free. Yeah.
Let the light in, keep it shining. Let it break into the darkness. All the love dares us to see. We'll all be free. So let the light in, keep it shining. Let it break into the darkness. All the love dares us to see. We'll all be free.
Let the lost be found. We gather here through our ups and downs. Come gather here, let's gather here. Let's walk in love.
Love is of God.
You can be loved.
To love is to know God.
There's a table for
all to receive
salvation.
Oh,
for the lost and found. A place for the brokenhearted. A space where your soul can heal. Word proven to deliver. A lost people now fulfilled.
A love
that endures forever. A cost sacrifice has paid. The answer to every question. A remedy for gift and shame. Come gather here, let the lost be found. We gather here through our ups and downs. Come gather here, let's gather here. Let's walk in love.
Love is of God.
You can be loved. There's a table for
all to receive
salvation.
Oh,
for the lost and found.
There is joy
for the lost and found.
I know there is peace
for the lost and found.
Yeah, that
for the lost and found.
I know you did.
Greetings, everyone. It is my pleasure to welcome you to gather to this monthly online experience where we share across our community, across the nation, across the sea, all of us who count gather as one of our spiritual homes. I'm Pastor Tim Wolf, and it is my pleasure to lead this congregation full of wonderful, committed, and passionate people who love Jesus and love one another. Welcome to gather. Because it's all because of Jesus. I love that song. It's all because of Jesus that we're here. That's the common thread that binds us together. And that's the person we follow. And that is the life we seek to emulate. And so right now, I invite you to join me in a word of prayer as we go into this time of worship. We're going to be a little on the edge today. We're going to be thinking and talking about some things that are very important to us as a community. And so we're going to be more in a contemplative space that I think you're going to enjoy. So join me in a time of prayer now. Lord, we thank you. God, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your grace. We thank you that you promise that where two or more gather in your name, you will be there. And so we say, welcome, Jesus. Welcome home. Welcome into your abode, God, both in our hearts and our souls and in this place we call gather. We invite your Holy Spirit to make itself known. God, I pray that your anointing will rest on this service. I pray that your Spirit will break up the fallow ground that's within us. I pray that your fire will set us on fire. Give us boldness, God. God, make us strong. Let us not be ashamed. Let us know that what you have called us to do is exactly what needs to be done at this moment for such a time as this. And in the end, the ways that you move and speak to us and you break us down and put us back together, everything that happens in this time of worship and praise and word together, in the end, all that's accomplished will be to your glory and for your praise. We ask this in the name above all names, the strong and powerful name of Jesus. Amen.
God is my shepherd. He goes before me, defender behind me. I won't fear. I'm filled with anointing. My cup's overflowing. No weapon can harm me. I won't fear.
So we sing hallelujah.
He always guides me through mountains and valleys.
His joy is refreshing.
His joy is refreshing.
It restores my soul.
Restores my soul. Mercy and goodness
gives me assurance.
Gives me assurance.
Oh, that I'll see His glory.
That I'll see His glory
face to face.
Face to face.
We can say,
Your Spirit lives within me, so I will walk in Your peace. Your Spirit lives within me, my victory,
Spirit.
Your Spirit lives within me, so I will walk in Your peace.
Your Spirit
lives within me.
My comfort
always holds me.
Hallelujah. We give you praise, God. Thank you, Lord.
Welcome to Gather. We're so glad you're here. Your presence enriches our community. And we pray that the experience will be joyful and heartwarming. At Gather, we are a family, growing together in understanding and sharing God's amazing love. At Gather, our journey is guided by 5 key principles. First, we are ecstatically inclusive, meaning we warmly welcome all people. No matter who you are or where you come from, you're welcome here. We celebrate everyone's unique story. Second, we're theologically progressive, inspired by Jesus, who always asked questions and challenged established practices. We embrace a forward-thinking approach to our spirituality and understanding of faith. We are socially committed. Gather is committed to societal matters, actively advocating for justice, equality, and positive change in our community and beyond. Then we are scripturally sound. At Gather, we clearly understand and adhere to a sacred text. While interpretations may differ, we firmly ground ourselves in the wisdom and teachings of sacred texts, viewing them as a base for our beliefs and actions. Finally, we are spiritually adventurous. We embrace the journey of discovery. We acknowledge the different forms of spiritual practices and experiences. We also recognize the mystery and depth of the spiritual life beyond established norms. Worship for the Gather family is an authentic expression of our gratitude and love for God. So as we gather, feel free to express your spirituality in whatever way that feels right for you.
Mother, mother, there's too many of you crying. Brother, 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 there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Yeah. Father, Father, we don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate.
You know we've got to find a way to bring some love and get here today.
Oh, picket lines and picket signs. Don't punish me with brutality. Talk to me so you can see. Oh, what's going on?
They judge us simply cause our hair is long.
Oh, you know that we've got to find.
Bring some understanding here today. Oh, oh, oh.
talk to me. You can't see what's going on. Yeah, what's going on? Tell me what's going on. I'll tell you what's going on. Ooh.
Right on. Right on.
Good afternoon, Gather family. Our text for today is Ezekiel chapter 34, verses 11 through 16 and 20 through 24. For thus says the Lord God, I myself will search for my sheep and will sort them out. As shepherds sort out their flocks when they are among scattered sheep, so I will sort out my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places to which they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries and bring them into their own land. And I will feed them on the mountains of Israel, by the watercourses, and in all the inhabited parts of the land. I will feed them with good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel shall be their pasture. There they shall lie down in good grazing land, and they shall feed on rich pasture on the mountains of Israel. I myself will be the shepherd of my sheep, and I will make them lie down, says the Lord God. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strays, and I will bind up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak, but the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them with justice. Therefore, thus says the Lord God to them, I myself will judge between the fat sheep and the lean sheep. Because you pushed with flank and shoulder and butted at all the weak animals with your horns until you scattered them far and wide, I will save my flock, and they shall no longer be ravaged, and I will judge between sheep and sheep. I will set up over them one shepherd, my servant David, and he shall feed them. He shall feed them and be their shepherd, and I, the Lord, will be their God, and my servant David shall be prince among them. I, the Lord, have spoken. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. So family, I found myself searching for the words, really any word, the right words maybe, to share with all of you today. As context before I begin, I'd like to share that I was in Israel in the occupied Palestinian territories for 11 days at the end of August with 22 of my students and two staff members of a campus religious center. Now, my heightened awareness and sensitivity around what is happening in the world and how its current climate is a mirror to that of what is happening on my own campus, disrupting the beloved community, has lent itself to anxiety, fear-inducing moments, and to say the least, it has been heartbreaking. My role as a university chaplain is to care for, hold, and support a community in both joys and sorrows, responding to the interconnected individual and collective physical, spiritual, emotional, and mental needs of my community. Yet how does one cultivate hope, wellness, and advocate for change when there really is so much going on in the world? Consider that as food for thought, and let us pray as we journey through and wrestle with this text, and really hear what God might have us to do as a Gather community during this time. Let us pray. Most loving and gracious God, I first say thank you for the opportunity to share a word with your people. God, may ears be open, hearts be open to receive the word. Now, Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, you are my strength, my rock and redeemer. Amen. So this text lends itself to naming Israel. Historically, as those people who were in the midst of the Babylonian exile. And it's also an account of the prophet Ezekiel, whose earlier proclamations to the Jews in Palestine were pronouncements of God's judgment on a sinful nation for its apostasy. Now, apostasy is simply a $10 word that means, within a broader context, those who embrace an opinion that is contrary to one's previous religious beliefs. Now, Ezekiel's survey of the people notes their lack of moral judgment, mistreatment or disregard for all people, an imbalanced trust of foreign gods with a little g, and alliances. In summation, Ezekiel says that Jerusalem was essentially a city full of injustice. Now, some of you might be sitting in this moment looking at your screens with your mouths now agape at the eerily accurate historical description of the text, even as we sit in this contemporary moment, now 51 days from the onset of the heinous terrorist Hamas attack on October the 7th in Israel, resulting in the killing of 1,200 Israelis and capture of 240 hostages. Since then, more than 13,000 people have been killed in besieged Gaza. Now, even in the midst of incomprehensible devastation and loss and death, this lectionary text perhaps can still offer us a look ahead to what has not yet come to pass. A blessed assurance that we can rest in the knowledge that we are called to have a faith in a faithful God. But I would argue, family, that faith without works is indeed dead. Now, why does faith require action? Let us consider this food for thought. First, we are called to rely on God's power and not of our own. That is one of the greatest critiques, perhaps, of this text and the world that we are living in right now. Humanity has become too reliant on its so-called shepherds or leaders, or sometimes even to themselves, to demonstrate power that does not care for or look after the well-being of the flock. We should be mindful of those whose expressions of power are not aligned with the liberating power and gospel of Jesus and what we say we believe as Christians. In verse 16, we are reminded that God will seek the lost and bring back the strays, bind up the injured, and strengthen the weak, but the fat and the strong God will destroy. God will feed them with justice. We believe in a God that encourages us even to bring good news to the oppressed, bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, in addition to a God that allows justice to roll down like water and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. I, God, will feed them with justice. Now that is food for thought. I would really encourage all of you to read the full text of this particular chapter, as the metaphor of the shepherd and leader and flock as the people is a through line in our text for today. It is God and God alone who will search, seek, bring, and gather God's people into action. And I believe that this faith in God also requires that we do something that only God can enable us to do. Our actions in this moment and in the future indicate who we place our faith in. Now, for those of you who remembered that $10 word apostasy, consider the ways of our action or inaction and how that demonstrates who or what we put our faith in. I would argue that those in the world who call themselves Christians but do not seek to understand the injustices of this world have little to no faith in anything at all. We cannot afford to judge between sheep and sheep and place value above one of God's most beloved creation over the other. We cannot afford to ignore what is happening in our world now and still vote the same way that we have always voted. We cannot afford to stay silent in our comfort of complicity. We, those who are called to walk the way of Jesus, cannot afford to embrace any opinion that is contrary to our religious beliefs. So Alice Walker says, look closely at the present you are constructing. It should look like the future you are dreaming. What is this present that the world is currently constructing? That some lives matter? That genocide can happen openly, publicly, and without impunity? That leaders like who speak truth to power can and will be silenced and shunned if no one is watching or speaking up and out? Now, I believe, like verse 13, that God will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries and bring them into their own land. It is faith in action when I see millions of people from a multitude of global countries, national and religious creeds, demonstrating in deep solidarity what they believe in and who they believe in. That allyship is not simply a title, but it is an action. We, family, cannot lose hope or think that God has abandoned God's people in spite of those who have been exiled or displaced, from Chicago to Sudan, to the Congo, to the Western Sahara, to Palestine. And the sheer neglect of leaders who are ignoring the flock's cries for help, aid, or ceasefire. We must learn to not only embrace, but to also embody what we believe in and who we believe in by co-creating and constructing a future full of hope of what the kingdom should look like right here on earth. And family, that embodiment of faith and action will call us to learn new things, to unlearn death-dealing theology or challenge antithetical religious beliefs from those that Bishop Tim has called bad preachers and phony teachers, and might I add, incompetent leaders. In verse 22, God's self will save the flock, as there is no place, none at all, for the abuse of power in and against the people by these so-called shepherds and incompetent leaders. While offering hope to those who have been ravaged, the text makes it very clear that it is the actions of the fat sheep that will bring about God's judgment and punishment. We as a community, as a gather family, are being called to not have church as usual. I believe the text is food for thought. Who are we being called to be in this moment? How do we embody God's presence at work in and through us for the liberation of all people? What does accountability look like to those who call themselves shepherds or leaders when they demonstrate no care or concern for their flock or the people? I know the Gather family to be a faithful community, committed to the inherent dignity and worth of all of God's people in the beautiful diversity of creation, committed to moral action and speaking truth to the injustices of the world. I believe these things to be so, and I believe we are being called to be this greater flock and demonstrate who we believe in and what we believe in. Amen, Ashe, and it is so.
What a powerful message. Tonight's sermon reminds us of our call to reflect God's justice and compassion in the world, and it challenges us to do so. Let us pray. Most holy, loving, and divine God, we thank you for your unwavering commitment to justice, seeking out the lost, and healing the broken. Lord, as you shepherd us with righteousness, instill in our hearts a deep hunger for justice, not just for ourselves, but for our neighbors near and far. Guide us to be agents of your love and fairness in a world that often wanders from the path of equity and kindness. May our actions reflect your mercy and your justice. May our lives be a testament to the transformative power of your grace. Teach us to live out the justice diet daily, serving others selflessly and striving for the world that mirrors your kingdom. It is in the name of Jesus the Christ we pray. Amen.
There's a world at war, caught in suffering, silent casualties. Oh God, grant us peace. In these sleepless nights, I can hardly breathe. Despite brutality, I know that we'll be free. I know that we'll be free.
So let the light and keep it shining. Let it break into the darkness. All the love dares us to see. We'll all be free.
In these desperate times, love will hold us here. Love will join our hands. Teach us to have no fear. So we lay our hate down to wash their feet. When we see our brother, oh, we'll all be free. Yes, we'll all be free. Yeah.
Let the light in, keep it shining. Let it break into the darkness. All the love dares us to see. We'll all be free. So let the light in, keep it shining. Let it break into the darkness. All the love dares us to see. We'll all be free.
Because this gospel is for everyone, at Gather, we believe the Lord's Supper is also for everyone. And every time we meet, whether in person or virtually, we take time to celebrate this feast of ecstatic inclusion when anyone and everyone is welcome to this table. There are other traditions that want to make this an exclusivist rite, that you've got to check this box and that box and this box in order to be seated at this table. But that wasn't true when Jesus initiated this rite. And so we are following Jesus and not another tradition that has tried to corrupt this idea. That's what this moment of communion is really about. It's a moment of witness, a moment of testimony, a moment when we sit down at the table and we dare to look across at the folks around us and realize not one of us is worthy of this gift, and yet all of us have been welcomed and embraced into this home. This dinner is always a welcome home dinner. So I say to you, welcome home, even as we pray and go into this time together. So God, we thank you for welcoming us home. We thank you for inviting us into your presence, for letting us know there is always a seat for us at the table and a seat for the next person and the next person and the next person, regardless how they identify, regardless what they believe, there is room for them at this table. God, thank you that we have been with you since the beginning. Thank you that we have learned just from being in your presence what everyone means, that all truly means all, and not one less than all means nobody. And so we accept the allness, the everyone-ness of this great gospel that you have declared and that you have entrusted to us. God, we've not always done a good job with this. Down through history, we have continually failed. We have always been given a gift, and then we have bungled the gift. You started with just the gift of your presence in the garden, and we messed that up. The gift of the law, and we messed that up. The gift of the prophets, and we messed that up. And then here you come, God made flesh to be the gift to us. And so many of us, even to this day, are messing that up, turning your witness, your work, your sacrifice into an excuse for hatred and violence. trying to put your gospel in the service to idols. But I know, God, that in the end, your word will prevail. Scripture says heaven and earth will pass, but my word, my word, hallelujah, my word will last. So we stand today on the word. We gather around this word at this table. And we bless you for this, God. We pray that you will be with us now in this time together. Wherever you are, find a little cup of something. Doesn't have to be juice, doesn't have to be wine. It can be whatever's handy for you. Find a cup of it. Find a piece of bread, a scrap of a cookie, a hot dog bun. It doesn't matter. Find something to be part of this witness, this meal as we go together. On the night when Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread and he broke it and he held it up and he said, this bread is my body. It's been broken for you. I've experienced spiritual terrorism. I know what the worst case scenario can be. And so when you're together, remember this about me and think about how you would care about me. And then I want you to extend that care to so many who, like me, have been victims of religious violence and oppression, political hatred. So when you're together, remember my body and what I suffered in my body. Remember me. And then he took the wine and he poured it into a cup and he said, this cup is a promise of a new day in my blood. So when you're together and you pour a glass of wine, remember me. Remember that there's a promise here that what used to be this brokenness, this brutality, this savagery that is being committed against innocent bodies, bodies that belong to me. When you think about that, remember there's a covenant, a promise in my blood of a new day. And so we come together and we take these gifts and we eat them and drink them together as a reminder, as a way of internalizing this truth that stands above all truths, a gospel we can never be ashamed of. Holy Spirit, we lift these elements up to you now. We invite you to imbue them with your presence. Feed us bread of heaven until we want no more. Water of life, quench our thirst so that we will never thirst again. God, and use this food to energize and empower and nourish us to go forth shamelessly to declare the good news of your gospel to everyone. We ask this in the name of all that is right and just and holy. The name of our Savior, our teacher, and our friend, Jesus the Christ. Amen.
We'll be free. Yeah. We'll all be free.
Dear gatherers, we are so grateful for all the gifts you share with us, both in giving your time and resources. We are also grateful for your financial support, whether tithing or weekly offerings. These gifts help us to grow our work and our outreach. Think about how you can help Gather grow through giving. You can give through PayPal, Givelify, or Zelle. And we are truly thankful for your generosity. Amen.
Well, family, I pray that you are blessed today and have indeed considered this food for thought. As we depart from this place, but never from God's presence, let us be reminded that God has given all peoples a common origin as God's creation, and it's God's will that they be gathered together as one flock. Fill the hearts of humankind with the fire and faithfulness of your love, O God, and it's your desire, God, to feed humankind with justice for all. May we as a community have the courage and strength to hold our shepherds and leaders accountable for seeds of division, strife, and war. And may there be a dawning of a humanity that is built on love and peace. We ask all of these things in your name. Amen.
Treasure so true, taken away by the splendor of your grace. You lift me up and